Please welcome Vice President RSA Conference, Linda Gray Martin. Good morning. On November the 9th last year, we learned with great sadness that Alan Palla had passed away. Alan was an early influential advocate for cybersecurity. He championed diversity, and he was incredibly passionate about mentorship and educating the next generation of cyber warriors. He was also instrumental in bringing the SANS panel to RSA Conference and was our moderator for over a decade, turning it into one of our most popular sessions. I know how many people here today knew Alan, respected him, and most importantly, loved him. Let's have a look at how some of those people remember him.
Please welcome Research Director and Founder, SANS Institute, Alan Palla.
Good afternoon. This is my favorite session of the year because this is the time when I find out what the really dangerous new things are that people are going to have to deal with.
Companies are also committing economic espionage, is what you're saying.
Companies are committing on a large scale, as are other governments. Many governments are using the same techniques that they're using for military espionage to learn enough to get an advantage in an economic transaction that they're undertaking.
Alan was a natural magnet for attention because, you know, he was always so action-oriented. I said, but no one was quicker to create a hero than Alan, right? To find someone else and to put them in the spotlight.
What was the best part of the competition?
It was probably hacking the score server. I compromised the Twitter feed. That was fun.
So you compromised the score and you gave yourself points?
Yeah, 10,000.
10,000.
For years, every weekend, Alan would call and for hours share new ideas he'd had for the cybersecurity community and how to make things better for our students. He was a rare form of wonderfully relentless.
Alan Powell is the Director of Research for the SANS Institute. He joins us this half hour. Give us an example of how cybersecurity would relate both to information analysis and infrastructure.
If you look around your kitchen, you've got electricity coming in, you've got a telephone line coming in, you may have the internet coming in, you have water coming in. 30 years ago, all those services were managed by people with valves. Today, all of those services are managed by computers.
He would raise you to levels that you didn't think were possible. He would praise your work and encourage you to keep driving even further.
He wanted to help people achieve their best. He was inspirational, truly motivational, and he touched the lives of tens of thousands of people.
Alan is the recipient of the RSA Conference 2022 Lifetime Achievement Award, very deservedly. Please welcome the president of the SANS Technology Institute College, Ed Skodis, who's accepting the award on behalf of Alan and his family.
Alan's wife, Marcia, and his daughters, Brooke and Channing, wanted to say a heartfelt thank you. What an honor it is for Alan to receive this Lifetime Award for the work he so passionately believed in and spent his life focused on. And if Alan were here today, we all know he would thank RSA Conference and all of you who continue to work so hard every single day to make cybersecurity better, to help make the world a safer, more secure place. As you know, Alan was focused on cybersecurity education and training up the workforce to fight the good fight. One of the last projects Alan worked on was the incredible National Cyber Scholarship Foundation. It's an organization dedicated to identifying and bringing up the next level of cybersecurity practitioners to keep us all safe. I urge you to look at the National Cyber Scholarship Foundation. It's just a fantastic thing. So Linda and RSA conference. On behalf of Alan and his family, we thank you so much for this award.
Thank you.